Today we're going to take a look at the Kamen Rider Gaim DX Sengoku Driver 2-pack. Now this is the little 2-pack that came with, well, this was released around the time of Gaim, which released the Sengoku Driver and the lockseed holder over there in a 2-pack. Bars them together. Now, forgive me if you see any paint scratches. I actually got this used off of Amazon. Yes, they have used. I don't know what that's about. Hey, it was better than paying $239 for just 8 things. 8 things. You might see 7, but we'll get to 8 in a bit. Other than, it was better of paying 75 than 240. Yeah. Yeah, it's weird. So, I'll be back, and so, now, let's go ahead and get everything situated so we can take a look at everything first and foremost. So, I'll be back. Alright, so here is the main belt, the Sengoku Driver. Now, forgive me for the glare and everything. It's just my windows. But here it is. Now, forgive me if there's any paint chipping again. So, take a look at this thing. Now, this is the bare body of the driver itself. This is before the faceplate and the lockseed is attached. This is all before that. Okay, so, let's take a look at this. Now, around the sides are a good little silver trim. You can see there is little bit of paint chipping right there. But around is a little tiny silver trim going around the driver. And looks to be 4 little tiny buttons. Three of which are not functional. Only this one is a button. Get to that. But there is the chopping knife. Oh, and around where the knife is attached is, just rip this off, is a nice little tiny silver trim around it, following where the blade would go. The blade itself is cast in a little grayish plastic. Black here, and it's mostly molded in black plastic with just the paint. All the silver you see here is all just plastic, except for a little tiny bit of this little rim. Of this rim plastic is a little bit sparkly. If my camera would focus. And there is a little bit of scuffing. Camera does not want to focus. And then we got this gold here. Which, focus camera. Focus. Don't focus on that. We got the nice sparkly gold. which does have a nice metallic finish. A little metallic finish through there. A little sparkly, as you can see right there. And the blade itself, from here to all the way over here, is a soft little bendy plastic to secure for no breakage. Now, the knife does come packaged separately from the belt, so you would just snap that on. Just snap it on like that, and that would basically be your core. But, this being a belt, it includes belt parts. And for some reason, those belt parts are needed. Hold on. Alright, I am back with the parts. So, this comes with a yellow little strap, which does have some scuffing on it, though. And here are the belt clips with, again, silver little focus, little silver trim all around. Hold on. Alright, I had to get that focused. It does have a little bit of buckle detail right there. It's the line. You got the line there, and then down here is like a little circle representing a belt. Now it's focusing. So, see, there's a little bit of scuffing thanks to me and everything else. So, there's a little bit of paint chipping. And there is the little silver trim. Little paint chip there, 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 there. But this is a simple system of buttons. There's a button on top, push that in. And a button on the bottom, push it back. And this is how it would attach to the driver. And it goes by a little simple system of an F, right side. There's an L and an L. You would depress the buttons and put it in, and then just clasp it up. Then just take it off. And it is two-way, so you can attach some other parts to it. So now, the reason these are detachable is because of a simple thing where these can come off and store together, and just store together nice and foremost, and the driver itself can operate on its own. I'll just stain it. So here is the left side with the parts, buttons, and for the right side, depress the buttons, boop, and on this side has the sticks for it. So, and it's simple to put together, and it does come with the little belt strap holder, which is soft, which is a hard plastic, but then with these parts right here, I mean, it's a hard plastic at the core, but then this top part, this side, and the bars here are all a soft plastic. It's hard at the core. It's hard at the core. Don't believe it. It is. But the way it would work, you take it, feed it through, take it all the way there, and then this slide in, and then we'll connect like that, and then bring the part to the middle, and now we have a little tiny belt strap like that. And then it would go simple ways. Take the sides and where's this one going? Put it in. That's not in. Stretch it around. And put that side in. Boom. Now we have a completed Sengoku driver. So now it is finally standing up on its fucking own. Anyways. So that is the belt in a nutshell. That is the main belt in a nutshell. But now we need to get down to the two other things that would go here. The thing they get their powers from and the faceplate for the rider. So we will put this thing off and take a look at this year's gimmick, the lockseeds. Now these are simple little things. This is Gaim's usual lockseed. Gaim's usual lockseed, orange, his base form. And these little things are basically padlocks. Just pop them open. But these are almost a little bit like the guy memories. Focus. So we'll get in. There's the orange there. Focus. Focus, camera. Focus. Thank you. So, you get the LS07, lockseed number 7, and get the orange there, right there, and there is a little bit of paint trimming around there, and a little bit on the tip of the orange, where the stem is. And it does actually have little tiny surface holes, worth enough. And it's a little padlock. So, how you would open Gaim's is just pop it open like that. And around all the little lock seeds is a nice metallic silver trim. Nice metallic silver trim. Come on. Focus for me. Focus. On the background. On this. Thank you. Come on, focus. But here is a shiny silver finish, and in the paint is actually a little bit of sparkle, a little bit of sparkleness. Now these actually have electronics, so on the bottom is a on off switch, and batteries are included, and say Pac-Man. Put back in. Right there. Sad little tiny Pac-Man. Sad Pac-Man. This is the battery cover. Speakers right here. And this thing takes three LR44s included. Turn on and you get line up the lock seed, very good. Listen to that again. bright orange LED inside there. So, now this is a DX lockseed, obviously. So, like any DX lockseed, unlike the Gashapon and the candy toys, right as you pop it open, it would make the unlock sound. Now, there is a difference between the three types of lockseeds. The Gashapon, the candy toys, and the DX. The DX have the lights in them. And when you pop them open, they'll make the little confirmation noise that you pop them open. Other than the Gashapon and the candy toys, where you would just pop them open, but then you would have to push the button on the back, which we will get to now. Now, in the show of Kamen Rider Gaim, there are little fighting battles called Invest Game, called the Invest Game. And when you would pop them open, when you would pop the lockseed open, it would reveal from the arms world, little fruit forest where these things come from. What were they? The invests would come out, and depending on the lockseeds, they would fight. And they would fight, and it'd be a little fighting game. So on the back, when you push the button, you would get three sounds. You get three sounds. Four. And so we'll just start. So press the button on the back, you get battle start. And then you would get the you win rank up, or a you lose, which is a rare one. So you get to get the you win rank up, but then randomized, you would get a you lose. So let's get that. And say you lose for that. And every time you push the button, the lockseed will light up. So there is LS07. Now this is supposed to be paired up with Gaim's little tiny driver faceplate. Here it is. It has Gaim's faceplate right there. And little tiny clouds or something. Silver trim around here. Get to that. And this is supposed to go onto the side of the driver. So get to that in a minute. So these are supposed to be paired up for Gaim. But then right out of the box, you get the second rider's lockseed and faceplate. So the second rider is named Baron. So we'll do the lockseed last. So here's the faceplate for Baron. Get Baron's faceplate right there. Sort of a vine or something. Sort of a vine design going around. And is a little bit of weird design. I love Baron. I love its design. Love lockseed also. And silver trim is carried over. And on the back, there is a little tiny tab. We'll get to that. But this is Marin's faceplate. But then, his lockseed is LS08 Banana. So, same deal. But this time, it is a banana with a sparkly little design of the banana. Obviously, a little bit of paint chipping right there. Paint chipping. And it is another padlock. Now, we'll get to something. That's a faceplate film. But with gaims and barons, there's actually a two-way system of the lock seeds. On gaims, this lock needs to be pushed back in order to unlock it. So you would basically pull it back. That's how it would pop that open. But with Baron, this one is a push-up one. So you push that up, it would pop open. Boop, boop, boop. And it's actually pretty nice. So, again, you get the silver trim. And on the top, behind the banana, is carried over that little tiny flake design. Like the little vine encased in a silver paint. Metallic silver paint. So, again, on-off switch is on the back. Screw right there, sat Pac-Man. Turn on, and you get a little trumpet noise and a bright yellow LED. So you would get that. So now. On all the lock seeds, the regular ones, like orange, all the Invis Games noises are the same. They would say battle start, or you win, rank up, or you lose. So, let's just try it. Oh wait, it's not on. It was like, I don't know. So, press it. Hey, we got the you lose run the first try, so you win rank up or you lose. So yeah. Why is it saying you lose now? Yeah, so the same universal sound. So, but different. Pop it open. Get the lights inside and says banana. And so that's Baron's Lockseed in a nutshell. But there is a little added bonus that I got with this set. This was the 2-pack, obviously. So, it also not only came with that, but the lockseed holder with gaim's first auxiliary lockseed, pine. So, first we will take a look at the holder. And this is supposed to go on the belts, or it can actually fit onto any regular belts. Let's have one here. It can fit on. It can fit on a regular belt, though it's loose on this one. Alright, and it's loose on this one. So on this, it's pretty simple. You just take a lock seed, just plug it on. And it's designed to clasp onto the lock seeds. See this little tiny metal bar? That is what the lock seed is for, to be held on to the parts. And when this thing is on, it's on. It takes quite a bit of force to take it off of there. And as you move, the lock seeds will hang. Almost like a real flute. Fruit. And on it is a little tiny silver trim, just like on the driver, going around the parts, going around, another little trim. So you can fit 3 lock seeds. But if you do buy this separately, you get. If you buy these 2 separately, you get this. You would get the driver and Gaim and Baron's lockseed, the orange and the banana, and their faceplates. But with this, you would get the lockseed holder and the LS05 pine. And this was Gaim's first little tiny auxiliary part. So this one, turn on, and you get inside. What's that again? Like, like an Indian sound or something. And it would light the lock seed. And the same are the Invis game sounds. Now, weirdly enough, on pine, the button is actually translucent, other than orange and banana here, which are just gray plastic. It's kind of weird. I don't know. But on this one, the pineapple is put in with the little pineapple. And around it is a black paint. Black little paint. Which, on that paint, is little tiny parts. And all this is actually raised, and even feel like the prickles of it, of the pineapple. And here there is major little point, part there, scuff, 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 scuffs, scuff, scuff. But nothing too major, who cares. But when you pop it open, you get pine. Get pine. That's a weird one. So this was Gaim's first auxiliary, so it's meant to go with orange. So there's a little tiny pear. So we got that. No. Turn all the lock seeds off for now. Alright, so now we're done. Now we're done with all that. Now, everything fell. So now, we will finally get on to the actual belt itself. Sengoku driver. Now, on the back, in the back here, on-off switch is on the back. Battery compartment is right here. It takes two AAAs, and speaker is up here behind the knife, right there, and on the switch is right there. So now there is no lights on the belt itself. Everything that is lights comes out of the lock seats. So turn on, and you get Sengoku Driver. So first, we will start with Gaim. So take Gaim's faceplate, and on here, it will slot in. And you get no noise. But when you chop, you get the little slice noise. And with the faceplates on, it does actually finish the little silver trim going around the belt. I just realized it's skin dark, so let me turn on a light or so. Ooh, it's getting hot in here. So now we will get on to the henching. So finally, it's been 30 minutes and we haven't even henching yet. So now we will turn on. So now, like Kota, henching. So now, we've popped this open. So now, we will put lockseed into the driver. So, and it will go in this little tiny crevice. So, lock it in. Ooh, nice bright light. So now, start, we will lock it up. With a little standby noise. A little disco. So now, to henching, we will slice it! Henching! That is bright as hell. But now, we have chopped the orange. So inside here is the chopped orange of... You have the chopped orange inside with little tiny candy corn slices going around it. And on the bottom here is the arm's weapon. Now, here you have transformed into Kamen gaim orange arms. Now, arms is referring to armor. Basically, if you haven't seen the show, all the lockseeds summon a different fruit, giving the rider two new things. New armor surrounding their upper body, like chest plates, shoulder pads, and a new helmet, and a new weapon, depending on the arms. Now, in this case, the orange arms has the weapon, the Daidaimaru. D-A-I-D-A-I-M-A-R-U. Or, as referred to a lot of people, the orange slicer. Yes, it is a little tiny orange blade. So, now, with this, now that we've changed, we can do a random of three attacks, depending on how many times you slice the fruit. So, you get one time, you get the scosh, slice, light up, and scosh. And you get the first attack, the orange scosh. Two times, you get the ole, which is basically a power-up attack. Get the little for two times, ole, and then three times, final attack, sparking. And there's sparking. Now, that's basically it. That's basically it for all the lockseeds. And all the henshin sounds are contained in the lockseeds themselves. So now we will pop this out. We will get
lock off.
So now we pop it out. And then close everything up and turn off the lockseed. So now there is one more little lockseed that we get for gaim, which is pine. So now we will use this. Take it, plug it in, light it up, and close it. Slice! Now, on camera, it may seem like a yellow light, but it's sort of like a brown, tan, yellowish light. Like a brown, a brownish light, sorta. And basically, it's supposed to represent, like, how a pineapple is. So, in the middle, we have the sliced pine. And pine arms is basically like big old bulky armor, as of a pineapple being bulky and very armory, I guess. But down here we have the pine iron, the weapon of the pine arms. And it's basically a little tiny chainmail running down to the end where it's a big old tiny pineapple. It's a little tiny pineapple. So now we will do our scotch, ole, and sparking. So once. Ole. And sparking. Alright, so there is pine. So pop it out. And that's it for gun. But now we can swap out this little faceplate. And we can now pop in Baron's faceplate.
Come on!
And we get come on! So now we need the banana. So pop it open.
Banana!
Banana! Spin it! And plug it in. Plug! And lock up.
Lock on.
Get a little trumpets. So now, henshin, we slice. Henshin! Naito spear. So here is pine arm. I mean banana arms. So now in the middle gets the little tiny banana, sliced banana, at the bottom, and now we get the banana arms weapon, the banana spear, little tiny banana lance. Usually get the little tiny peeled effect at the hilt of it. So now, attacks. Scosh!
Come on! Banana scosh!
Get the end like the little, like the stab. Like the stab of the banana spear. Scosh. I mean, ole. Little powered up noise. I always laugh about those. And finally, sparking. Come on, banana sparking. And there's sparking. So that's it. That is it for the Sengoku driver. So, what do I think about it? It's great. It's a great toy. And even after 40 minutes of taking a look at this darn thing, is it worth it? Yes. Though it doesn't do much, it started the way of one of the greats, of one of the greatest, one of the greatest toy lines of Kamen Rider, like one of the most greatest gimmicks of Kamen Rider, along with the gaim memories, one of the best, along with those. Let's pop it out. Lock off. Pop it out. Lock it up. And locked up. So that's it. So is it worth it? Yes. 5 out of 5. Goodbye. Daihenshin.